Hello friends, in this session I am going to talk about a very important topic in computer architecture, which is referred as pipelining. One thing that I would like to stress before I start, before I go deeper into is, this is not a cakewalk and this requires strong attention. If you say you know computer architecture, you are expected to know very much about pipelining and what is it all about, what are all the stages in pipelining, what all the kinds of hazards that you will get when you go for pipelining. All this stuff you are definitely expected to know, and it is actually a very important topic which requires some special attention. So let us go into it. Step by step I will take you through, but again it is very tough, so please listen carefully. If you have any queries, you can always post it back to me through the comments section. So what is pipelining? Very simple. When I am talking to you now, I know what to talk next, so my brain has already pipelined what I need to talk next. Why it has to be done? Very simple. I need not waste time in thinking what I should talk by the time I complete the first topic, and I will have to navigate to the second topic. That's exactly the point. I need to save time. Let us consider the assembly line where cars or bikes or any automobile is manufactured. Let's consider the painting stage. When the first vehicle is painted, the second vehicle should be readily available for the painting to be started. This is called pipeline. Why it should be ready? They cannot waste time. Obviously, time is to be saved. So, now let's come to the computer architecture. What is pipelining? A pipelining is a simple technique where processor can be made to work efficiently, faster. When multiple instructions can be handled at a time, it becomes obviously faster. Throughput will be increased. That's the point. So now the question is not if your architecture is pipelined or not, because most of the architectures that whatever we are going to see or we have seen are pipelined. So what is the question now? The question is your architecture 5-stage pipeline or 7-stage pipeline? Don't worry about all this. I'll explain you this clearly in the near future. Let's take a simple example. I am going to take an example of washing clothes. What do you mean by that, sir? Very simple. I let collect all the clothes which are to be washed, and then I need to go to my, you can see that here, I need to go to my washing machine. I will wash it first, then I'll move it on to the dryer to dry the clothes which are already wet, and then after that I need to go to the stage of ironing, and then I will iron. The process is over. This is stage 1, I need to wash. Stage 2, I need to dry. Stage 3, I need to iron. So these are all called stages of pipelining. That's it. Stages of the instruction. An instruction has to be fetched, decoded, executed. You can simply understand that way. Now I'm going to take a better example for you to understand how exactly pipelining can be related to this concept. Assume that we have got man A here, who is going to first wash his clothes for 10 minutes, and then he will dry his clothes for 10 minutes, and then he will iron the clothes for 10 minutes, and it is all over. So totally man A needs 30 minutes. Assuming there is no pipelining supported, man B will come, he will then do it for 30 minutes, man C will come, then he will do it for 30 minutes. So totally 30 plus 30 plus 30 is 90 minutes is needed if there is no pipelining supported. Now we assume that there is pipelining supported. How do we go about it when we have pipelining enabled here? Very simple. Man A will complete washing in 10 minutes. Then he will push it on to a drying stage. By the time he goes to drying stage, the washing machine is free. So man B can come here and he can start washing his clothes. By the time man A completes the drying process, he will go to the ironing stage. So now drying machine will also be free. So man B can go to drying machine, but he would have freed the washing machine. So man C can enter and he can use the washing machine now. So when one equipment is being used, when a particular equipment is being used by a first stage, I mean the first instruction, it becomes free in the next stage so that the next instruction can use it. Man A is an instruction, man B is an instruction, man C is an instruction. Instruction A needs 30 minutes, instruction B needs 30 minutes, instruction C needs 30 minutes. But overall, when we have pipelining, you can see that 30 plus 10 extra plus 10 extra, it will end in 50 minutes. So pipelining is an art where you make sure that you enhance the throughput. What is throughput? The throughput is nothing but number of work you are doing or number of results that you are giving in a particular amount of time. And most important point, you cannot achieve pipelining if you do not have all these as individual components. I need a washer separately, dryer separately, iron separately, otherwise it is not going to work. If all of them are in one dabba, I will not make it work. It is not going to work that way. Now, let us answer one very important question. Will pipelining increase throughput? Yes, pipelining is going to increase overall throughput. Will pipelining increase efficiency for single load? No, it is not going to do that. Every person needs to spend 30 minutes in washing. It is not going to increase efficiency for one single person, but overall it will increase efficiency for the entire set of loads which are to be handled. Let me repeat, pipelining is an art where you are going to increase the throughput, increase the efficiency for a lot of loads, and it is a method where you are utilizing the processor most efficiently. I'll come back to you with more content on the same topic in my next session. Thank you very much for following my content. I'll come back to you shortly. If you have any comments, please go ahead and type it. And if you like the content, please subscribe. And you can ask me a question as well, which I will try to answer if at all I know. Otherwise, I can refer and come back to you. Thank you.